Hi, my name is Jacob Kanigan. Welcome to this virtual presentation on deep unsupervised representation learning from Accelerometer Time Series for animal activity recognition. I will show you that unsupervised representation learning is useful for animal activity recognition and the quality improves as more unlabeled data becomes available. The activity of animals is a rich source of information that not only provides insights into their behavior, life and well-being, but also their environment. Activity information supports applications including wildlife conservation, the detection of environmental effects such as forest fires and poaching, and livestock management. It is difficult to find and observe wild animals, and obtaining labeled data is tedious, labor-intensive, and costly, while it is much easier to obtain large volumes of raw unlabeled data. Activity datasets are naturally imbalanced because some activities are either not frequently performed or challenging to observe for ground-truth labeling. In our paper, we analyzed the quality of unsupervised representation learning techniques and compared them with traditional feature extraction methods. We investigate the impact of the size of the labeled and the unlabeled dataset. And finally, we evaluate the impact of depth in the feature architectures. We used real-world time series motion data from goats and horses that was collected using lightweight and energy-efficient accelerometers. Specifically, we compared time and frequency domain summary statistics with three unsupervised techniques: principal component analysis, a deep net of two-stacked sparse autoencoders, and a generative convolutional deep learning network comprising two-stacked convolutional restricted Boltzmann machines. Both the deep net and CDBN were trained by query layer-wise training, and all representations were evaluated by training a support vector machine for the classification task. Using this method, we performed three experiments. First, we varied the size of labeled data used for SVM training while using 100% as unlabeled data for representation learning. Second, we varied the size of unlabeled data for representation learning while using 50 labeled samples per class for SVM training. Third, we varied the depth by using activations from different layers as representations. Because we use two datasets that have different levels of imbalance, we observe and discuss the effect of imbalance on the performance in the paper. As the labeled dataset size grows, our results show that unsupervised representations can outperform engineered features. When varying the size of the unlabeled dataset, the performance of CDBN benefited the most from an increasing amount of unlabeled data, especially in the more diverse and imbalanced dataset. Thanks for listening, and please check out our paper for more details and further discussions. Our results motivated further analysis of generating models such as GANs and variational autoencoders.